Hey, this is Ian Westerman. I'm the head pro at EssentialTennis.com, where it's my mission to bring passionate instruction to passionate players just like you. And in today's lesson, I've got a treat for you. We're going to be analyzing a forehand swing from Roger Federer. I've traveled around and shot a lot of professional practice court footage. This is, you know, when I think about all the footage I've shot, this individual swing is my favorite swing I think I've shot of any player, anything that I've ever shot. This always kind of comes back to me. The lighting was perfect, the framing was perfect. You know, this is like the one shot that I think about when I think about my favorite footage that I've shot. So that was kind of my inspiration for this lesson. And we're gonna take this individual shot and I'm gonna break it down into six things that you can copy so that you can make your forehand better. Okay, we're not gonna drill down and get super detailed and nerdy. These are gonna be practical things that you can copy from Roger Federer. And even better, I'm gonna give you a PDF download that's gonna have a freeze frame image of all six of those elements. There's gonna be a link to download that PDF in the description right below this video. So I hope you take advantage of that and you appreciate that. All right, let's get right to it. So first and foremost, I'm just gonna go ahead and just play through this swing so you get a sense of what's going on here on the court. I love this shot, everything about it. And technique-wise, we're gonna go ahead and break down, again, into six different parts here. We're just gonna spend maybe 30 seconds, a minute at the most on each of these elements. First and foremost, you'll notice, look at where he starts. Check out his right foot. It's just about in line with the hash mark on the baseline here, maybe a little bit to the left. Watch how far he moves to his left to hit this forehand. He moves a good 6, 7, maybe even 8 feet off to his left in order to position himself for a forehand. And this is something that most tennis players need to do more of. Roger Federer has a great backhand, but we all know that his forehand is far superior. He knows that, so as often as possible, he will hit his forehand instead of his backhand. And this is something that you need to copy and do a better job of taking advantage of, because there are lots of opportunities on the court for you to hit your favorite shot. And maybe it's your backhand, I don't know, but you need to hit your favorite shot more often, okay? The second thing we're gonna look at is his preparation right here. And two main things that you absolutely can implement into your own swing. Number one, a strong unit turn. From the hips up, he's rotated his body a full 90 degrees. His chest is facing directly out to his right towards his side fence here. And there's other things we can look at as well. I love that his left arm is out across his body. He's focused on the ball, looking over the top of his left shoulder here. Those are all great things. But really the most important thing is this rotation of his upper body, his rotation of his core. And notice his balance as he prepares. If you just look at this freeze frame here, it would be virtually impossible to tell that this was a shot that he hit in motion. This freeze frame here makes it look like he's completely stationary and static and getting ready to just hit a forehand. The reality is he's moving, he's in motion right now, but his balance is so good that he's solid. These are things that you should be definitely working on hard to try to emulate. All right, number three, I want you to look at this position here. Look at how his chest is now facing the ball. He's now made a 90 degree turn with his upper body. Remember, we looked at his preparation right here, his chest facing directly to his right. Now, this is, in the grand scheme of things, well before he hits the ball, notice that his chest is facing forwards towards the ball already, even though his racket is still back behind him, relative to his body. It's back behind his body now that he's rotated his chest forwards. This means that his core, his upper body, the big, strongest parts of his body have initiated the swing. His torso, his chest, his core, you know, his abs, his back, that upper body rotation has initiated the forward momentum of his racket, as opposed to so many tennis players, and you may be one of them, the best way to tell is to videotape yourself hitting forehands. So many tennis players move their body as one big piece. This is called the kinetic chain. Using the different parts of your body in succession smoothly and powerfully and efficiently. And a big part of that is using the body, the core, to initiate that forward movement. And then the arm and the racket and the hand follow behind. And you'll see that here on the screen. Look at how his racket is still pointing towards the back, backdrop. And look at how his hand and his wrist are now laid back. That's because his upper body initiated a powerful forward swing, and his hand and his wrist and his arm were relaxed. And that's the other main thing I want to point out about this position. I think a lot of players try to emulate this by forcing their hand back, by like laying their hand back, you know, on purpose, pushing it back there. It's my belief, in my opinion, I feel pretty strongly about this, that high-level players get to that position simply because they're relaxed and loose. And their upper body has initiated that forward turn, and their hand and their racket naturally lays back because they're relaxed. It's not that he's pushing the racket back there and saying, all right, I gotta lay the racket back now. His upper body initiated that turn forwards, and his hand and his racket, because they're loose and relaxed, his hand and his wrist, his racket can't really be relaxed, laid back naturally as a part of that kinetic chain, that rotation forwards, okay? So, number four, we're gonna go on to contact. And this individual freeze frame here, this is a big reason why I love this capture here, this footage so much. I absolutely love this individual frame of footage here. Out of all the footage I've ever shot, this is probably my single favorite frame of pro footage. Look first and foremost at his extension of his arm forwards towards contact. That's one of two things I want to point out about contact here. You'll notice his chest still is facing forwards. Now his arm and his racket have caught up and they've made contact with the ball. He's hit right in the middle of his racket. This extension is incredible and awesome. It shows amazing timing. And this is just a strong physical position for him to be in, extending out to make contact with the ball. So many tennis players they're jammed. They've positioned themselves too close to the ball, and they get into this weak, kind of folded up, scrunched up position at contact, and there's so little potential there to accelerate the racket. This extension, and it's going to be different depending on what grip you use, et cetera, but generally speaking, the concept of giving yourself room to swing and extend and allow your body to move powerfully and freely is crucial. And this is something you should be working on. And I also want to point out at contact here, I mean, Federer is just so well known for this. His focus on the ball is just legendary, like literally legendary. There's so many freeze frames of him focusing at contact, you know, beyond where he made contact with the ball, meaning beyond the point in time where he made contact with the ball. This steadiness and this focus with his body and, you know, his head and his eyes is just incredible. And that's something that absolutely everybody can get at least a little bit better at. Now moving on, two more points. I want to point out his balance. Look at how far he came up into the air to hit this shot. And you know, we can't see the ground here below him, but he got off the court pretty well here to make contact. But notice as he comes down, how he maintains the balance with his body. Still, you know, straight up and down. He hasn't even touched down on the court yet. Now he's touched down. You get a sense of how long he was up in the air there, but he maintains his balance so beautifully. And whether or not you get off the court really is irrelevant. You want to strive to be in that much control of your body and have that much balance through the point of contact, not just up until you hit the ball, but through the point of contact. And the last thing I'm going to point out is watch how after he lands, he immediately pushes off his outside foot and starts pushing back towards the middle of the court. It's because he's recovering back to the middle in anticipation of any possible shot. He's run around this to hit a forehand, which means he's left open some court here. So he needs to recover immediately and watch closely what his opponent is doing to try to anticipate whether or not they're going to be in a position to try to catch him with their next shot. So we went through that relatively quickly. I wanted to really kind of break this down and give you the six, what I thought were the six most important, vital, most essential elements that all of us can work on and take away from this. Not detailed, you know, individual technique things that, you know, all players have their own little idiosyncrasies. These are all things that are foundational that you can improve, that you can get better at. Again, videotape yourself so you can see how you match up as far as all six of these elements are concerned. And please be sure to take advantage of the PDF that I've linked up down below. There's a link in the description of this video. Completely free download there, a PDF that shows all six of the points. There's bullet points there to remind you what the most important elements were that we talked about today. So all you have to do is let me know where to send that, and you'll get it in just a couple seconds from now. So take advantage of that download. Hopefully you found this video helpful and you find the PDF helpful as well. If you've enjoyed this video, do me a favor and click like if you're watching on YouTube. Also, be sure to subscribe to the Essential Tennis YouTube channel so you don't miss out on future videos just like this one that I publish on a regular basis. And lastly, if you have any comments or questions about anything you saw today, leave that down below in the comments. And with that, I'll sign off. Thank you so much for watching. Take care and good luck with your tennis.